Hi guys, this is going to be an informal video about the RPI ratings as of February the 14th for college basketball. Some of you are probably not familiar with the RPI. I'm just learning about it, really, you know, taking a look at it and understanding its meaning. So I thought I'd pass on that knowledge to some of you who may not know what the RPI is. Basically, the RPI is a list of teams that the selection committee is most likely to select come selection Sunday in about a month and a week or so. And some of the teams that are on the RPI are going to make it because they win their conference championship. And some of them will be considered at large bids. That is, after all the conference tournaments are finished, the selection committee will pick 36, I believe it is, teams that will also be entered into the brackets in the NCAA tournament for March Madness. So I thought you might find this interesting. And if you are in an office pool, if you're in some kind of pool in general, where you have to select the brackets, this may be helpful to you. But remember now, the NCAA is a wild card. There are teams that are low ranked that can beat high ranked teams. It doesn't happen that often. Matter of fact, last year, there were the least amount of Cinderellas that I can remember. So, but Cinderella can always pop up. That's what you got to be aware of. And usually that's what makes your brackets successful when you pick those Cinderella teams to upset maybe, let's say, a 5 seed or 6 seed. Very rarely will a low-seeded team. When I say low-seeded, I mean, yeah, you know, a higher number in the seeding, like a 12 or 14, 15, 16, will be the number 1 or 2 or 3. That's not going to happen. So this should give you a gauge, too, on some of you have teams that are on the bubble. So you should be able to figure out from this list I'm about to show you, if your team is going to make it, if your team needs to win the next 4 or 5 games, if your team needs to win the conference tournament to get in, the higher the number, the least likely your team is to make it. I should say, after 36 teams, the higher the number, the more least likely it is for your team to make it. In general, I would say the first 32 teams that I show you will make the tournament, either as an at-large bid or as an automatic bid by winning their conference championship. Only team that doesn't have a conference championship, or I should say the only conference that doesn't have a conference championship, is the Ivy League. So it looks pretty much like Harvard's going to win that, unless Yale can just all of a sudden put on a burst and Harvard lose 2 or 3. But it looks like Harvard from here. So this is not the same as a power ranking. Don't get it confused. Because when you see the number one RPI team, that just means that team has the greatest potential to be in the tournament, even if they don't win their conference championship. Okay, that's all I take from it. Now, you may have another take on the RPI that I don't. But it's basically strength of schedule, strength of conference ranking, okay? So if you got a weak schedule, if you're not playing, you're playing a bunch of weak sisters, then, and you got a great record like 28-2, but you haven't played anybody, you might not make the tournament, depending on the selection committee and how they view your conference, how they view your team overall. So it's kind of tricky, but it's pretty easy to figure who will make it. Seeding is a different thing, so we'll get to that at another time. Okay. Here, I'm just going to read them off to you. Okay, I'll just go number one, number two, like that. And these are RPI rankings for the NCAA. Okay, Division I. Number one, Kansas. Number two, Arizona. Number three, Syracuse. Number four, Florida. Number five, Villanova. Number six, Wisconsin. Number seven, Wichita State. Number eight, Duke. Number nine, Kentucky. Number 10, Michigan State. Number 11, Iowa State. Number 12, Creighton. Number 13, Michigan. Number 14, Cincinnati. Number 15, St. Louis. Number 16, UCLA. Number 17, Virginia. Number 18, Ohio State. Number 19, San Diego State. Number 20, Massachusetts. Number 21, Gonzaga. Number 22, Texas. Number 23, Virginia Commonwealth. Number 24, Toledo. Number 25, Colorado. I said cot. Okay, I'm turning my page here. Give me a second, guys. I'm doing this in real time. I'm not editing it. These are from my notes. Okay, number 26, George Washington. Number 27, Pittsburgh. Number 28, Connecticut. Number 29, Oklahoma. Number 30, Kansas State. Number 31, Memphis. Number 32, Louisville. Number 33, North Carolina. Number 34, Iowa. Number 35, New Mexico. Number 36, Oklahoma State. Now that would be the pivotal point right there, 36. That would be how many at-large bids there would be. But realistically, a lot of the teams that I just read you in the first 36 are going to win their conference championships also. So that RPI won't affect these teams' chances, those teams that win their conferences' chances of getting into the tournament, since winning your conference championship is an automatic bid, okay? So now the tricky part for when you're trying to figure out who's going to make it into the tournament is these next 37, because the first 36 that I read you, they're almost locks to either win, like I said, their conference, or to be selected as an at-large bid. Okay, so now it's kind of shaky. That's why I'm giving you 100, because it could flip-flop. Today is February the 14th, 2014. These RPIs could flip-flop depending on how many games a certain team loses, how many games a certain team wins. Oklahoma State, for instance, let's say they lost their next three. They might drop all the way down to 70-something. They're right now, they're at 36. So it's kind of tricky and hard to gauge, but it's still a good indicator of who might make the tournament. So let's continue. I left off with 36, and that was Oklahoma State. 37, Arizona State. 38, Minnesota. 39, SMU. 40, Richmond. 41, South Mississippi. 42, Oregon. 43, Missouri. 44, Xavier. 45, St. Joseph's. 46, Stanford. Number 47, North Dakota State. 48, California. 49, BYU. 50, Tennessee. 51, North Carolina State. 52, St. Mary's. 53, Baylor. 54, Indiana State. Remember now, there's only 68 teams that are going to make the NCAA tournament. These are the teams where I'm stopping at 54 here just to explain this. These are the teams most likely, after those 32 automatic bids are given out, these are the teams most likely to make it into the tournament. So if these teams don't win their tournament their conference championships, then these indicators are what the selection committee is going to look at. This is a strength of schedule, strength of conference rating. It's not ranking the teams number one, number two, number three like that. It's just going by a formula that they've devised to say if a team's played a legitimate amount of stiff competition. So I left off at 54, Indiana State. 55 is Harvard. 56 is Dayton. 57 is Georgetown. 58 is Providence. 59 is Boise State. 60 is St. John's. 61, Ole Miss. 62, Nebraska. 63, Florida State. 64, Belmont. 65, LSU. 66, West Virginia. 67, Delaware. 68, Clemson. 69, Wisconsin Green Bay. 70, Mercer. 71, Maryland. 72, Washington. 73, Marquette. 74, Ohio. 75, Louisiana Tech. 76, Arkansas. 77, Illinois. 78, UC Santa Barbara. 79, Oregon State. Number 80, LaSalle. 81, Eastern Michigan. 82, Wake Forest. 83, Wyoming. 84, St. Bonaventure. 85, New Mexico State. 86, Middle Tennessee State. 87, Manhattan. 88, Iona. 89, Georgia State. 90, Stephen F. Austin. 91, Indiana of the Big Ten. 92, Utah. 93, Akron. 94, Vanderbilt. 95, San Francisco. 96, Missouri State. 97, Northwestern. 98, Pacifica. 99, Cleveland State. And this is the last one that I recorded. It's as number 100 because they go on all the way. I think 300 teams get ranked or something like that, maybe more. But the number 100th, the 100th team is Georgia. Okay, so what do you take from the RPI that you've just heard? Well, what you take from it is your team, if you're in that Hot 100 I just listed, you got a chance. Some of you got a better chance than others. Let's say Georgia, for instance. Georgia's number 100. They need to win out. That's obvious. Another team that would need to win out would be Northwestern, and they still might not make it, them or Georgia, because they're bubbles. They're really on the bubble. And their conferences may already have too many at-large bids for them to get one. Okay? Now, the teams that got a great chance are the first ones that I read, like the Kansas, the Arizona, the Syracuse, the Floridas. Those are so obvious. Villanova, Wisconsin, I'm not so sure they should be six on the RPI based on a little losing streak they've had lately. I don't have anything against Wisconsin. I'm just saying, you know, I don't think they should be higher than on the RPI than Michigan State is. But anyway, then again, I have to catch myself and remember the RPI is not, and I repeat, is not a ranking of the teams. It is simply a percentage that is attached to teams' likelihood of making the NCAA tournament. So in that vein, you know, I may have to take back what I said about Wisconsin and Michigan State because they're both within the top 10 of the RPI, so that means they're going to make it. Basically, all of the teams, I would say the top 25 teams, you're in. There's nothing they can really do to lose it, the top 25. So I'll read the top 25 again. This is the top 25 in the RPI. They're going to either make it by winning the conference championship or an at-large bid. Kansas, number one. Arizona, number two. Everybody's agreeing with me as I go along this list, I know. I'd like to hear in your comments if you disagree with any of these top 25 teams making it into the NCAA tournament. Okay, I think three was where I left off with Syracuse. Four, Florida. Five, Villanova. Six, Wisconsin. Seven, Wichita State. Eight, Duke. Nine, Kentucky. 10, Michigan State. And I got to say this. A lot of people are picking Michigan State to win it all. They've had a lot of injuries to their team, and now everybody's coming back right at tournament time. So that's a team, if you're filling out your office brackets, your pool for your office brackets, you better put Michigan State up there high because they are a powerhouse team that's been limping along and still winning, but they've lost a few too, like Wisconsin has. Number 11 is Iowa State. Number 12 is Creighton. Creighton used to be considered a mid-major, but now they're in the Big East. I don't think they're considered a mid-major since the Big East is a BCS conference. I think the teams are eligible in the Big East in football to be in the BCS, which is an obsolete formula, by the way. That won't be next year. But let me move on. Number 13 is Michigan in the RPI rankings, just by schedule and conference. And a team that's high in the rankings might be in this RPI lower in the numbers because of their strength of schedule or their conference. It's a tricky thing, but these are pretty good indicators. 14 is Cincinnati, 15 is St. Louis. I think we all agree all of these teams will make it, right? 16, UCLA, 17, Virginia, 18, Ohio State, 19, San Diego State. Somebody stop me when you hear one you don't think will make the top 25. As far as making it into the tournament, either at large or conference, winning the conference championship. These teams have a high probability of making it in the tournament. And when I finish here, I'll expand on that to make it even plainer for you. Ohio State is 18. I think I said Virginia was 17. I think I may have skipped them. As I said, UCLA at 16, Virginia 17, Ohio State 18, San Diego State 19, Massachusetts 20, 21 Gonzaga. A lot of people ragging on Gonzaga. These so-called analysts, they saying their schedule's too weak and all of that. But we'll see. Gonzaga always surprises. I wouldn't count them out in the NCAA tournament. Texas is 22, 23 is Virginia Commonwealth. 24, this is a team that's going to be a Cinderella. I'm already predicting it. Toledo at 24. So if you fill it, excuse me, if you're filling out your brackets, I would consider Toledo to be a Cinderella, possible bracket-breaking team. And at 25, Colorado. Now, here's the best way to explain in a plain language what I just read you the top 25 RPI teams are. If you were placing a bet in Las Vegas for teams to make the tournament, these teams represent the best odds of teams that are going to make it. So let's say you bet on Toledo to make the NCAA tournament. Seeing as how on the RPI, they're 24, though you may have never heard of them, Toledo's going to make the tournament. Okay? Unless they have a conference. Some conferences are tricky. If you don't win the conference championship, you can't go to the NCAA. But most of them will accept an at-large bid from the NCAA selection committee. But I've heard of it where a team didn't win their conference championship, had the best record, and didn't make the NCAA tournament because somebody got hot in the conference championship and they got that automatic bid and that team was left out. These are usually, and I don't mean no disrespect, but these are usually in lesser conferences, you know, that you don't see games on TV, or if you see them, they're on ESPN 999. You know what I mean? So that's pretty much it for this video on the RPI power ranking. It's not really the power rank, it's the RPI rankings for the top 100 teams in college basketball, Division I. Hopefully this was an informative video, and I'm going to put up some other stuff for people who are going to be studying the tournament. I'm going to give you some facts and figures from teams from last year and how they made the tournament and where they were ranked and blank, blank, blank. And then you can kind of get a better feel for this video if you want to listen to it again. These power rankings are for February the 14th, 2014, and are subject to change before the tournament starts. Though I don't think any team will move more than 15 spaces up or down in this RPI ranking of the top 100. Some teams might fall off the shelf. Injuries, all kind of things could happen. Like I said, lose the conference championship, blah, blah, blah. Okay? So hopefully, guys, you found this informative. Take it easy.